It's me, Abby, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, I am going to be doing 10 life hacks for back to school. Now, the holiday season is over, which means school is starting again. And even though it's not a fun thought to think about, hopefully these hacks will make it a lot easier for you. So let's get started with number one. Okay, so this is a hack that I cannot stress enough. For the first hack of this video, I am going to be telling you to be prepared. Now, you might be wondering what that is meaning and what context I'm putting this in, but what can I say? You need to be prepared, whether it is with anything that you can't just throw around in your bag. So, I got this little toiletry bag to help me out with this hack. So I'm not going to be using it for toiletries exactly, but with COVID going on in school, it is always best to be prepared because you never know what can happen. First off, you might want to take an extra mask. Now, I cannot tell you what would happen with your mask, but an extra one is always best to have in any situation. So let's put that in our little toiletry bag. Next up, tissues. Tissues is always better than to ask the teacher for tissues or to go to the bathroom for it if you don't have any. So pack a pack of 10 ply tissues, I think. Yeah. Put it in there. Lip balm. If you have like chapped lips during the day, lip balm is always a good thing to have in your little be prepared bag. So let's plop it in there. A little mini hand sanitizer. Now you could ask your parents to get this if you don't have it yet, because it is definitely a necessity. Okay, after this, we have some throat spray. This is a medicine for if your throat is hurting bad during the day. You do not want to feel bad at school, so this is the way to go. This basically numbs your throat and it's called Andolix spray. So yeah. And next up, if you have to go to gym class or anything, roll on. Deodorant is the way to go. So this is not the only thing you can put in this bag. I cannot tell you what you can put in this bag, considering that this is going to be your decision. You can put in feminine hygiene, a lot of other things, but these are definitely the necessities. Maybe an extra pencil and eraser for in case you forget it. You will have it. So let's close this up and let's get on with the next hack. Hack number two, the night before you need to go to school, make sure you pack your bag. Now, the morning rush is terrible on school mornings, but one hack that can make it a lot easier is to pack your bag the night before. This just causes you to not feel as stressed in the morning, because let's be honest, the thought of running around looking for books and things is just not something you want to have in the morning. So make sure you pack your bag the night before. Little hack, remember extra pencils, paper, and anything you need, because we do not want to have that forgotten. Okay, so extra pencils, extra erasers, extra pencil sharpeners, because borrowing in COVID is also not the safest and healthiest thing to do. So pack in your books, don't forget your be prepared bag, your pencil case, anything you need. Make sure it is packed and put in a safe space so that you don't need to feel rushed the next morning. Now, this is definitely a hack that's going to help you guys a lot. Hack number three. Now, make sure you have this, a shower routine. Now, there has been going around a lot whether you should shower in the morning or the night. Personally, I like showering at the night, but I can totally understand why people shower in the morning, to feel fresher and feel more awake. Now, personally, when I shower at night, I usually wash my face in the morning just so that I can get that little kicker up and feel great. But make a shower routine, because wherever you are going, it is important to smell good at school. Now, school isn't a fashion show, it is there to learn, but personal hygiene is a necessity. Whether or not you are going to a restaurant or going to school, it is good to know when you need to shower and when not to, you know? So you definitely want to figure that out for yourself, because I'm not going to be telling you whether you should shower in the morning or the night. But that is a great, great hack to keep you guys in schedule and ready for the next day. Hack number four, going to bed on time. Now, this is something so many teenagers, including myself, struggle with. How to go to bed on time. Now, you might be thinking it's a lot more fun to just lay in bed and scroll on TikTok, past 1 a.m. But let me tell you why this is so bad. Not only is it bad for your health, but it is bad for your day the next day. Think about it. You spend 6 or more hours at school every single day where you need to learn and focus. And going to bed late isn't doing you a favor at all. I mean, you're going to be feeling tired and low on energy all day and you won't be able to focus correctly. So, set your time schedule and be disciplined. Please guys, be disciplined. Whether it is going to bed at 11 p.m. for teenagers or going to bed at 8 or 9 p.m. for younger children, just make sure you get a full 6 to 8 hours of rest and you will feel like a princess next morning. Now, lights off. Hack number 5. Now you might be hearing this everywhere. Be healthier, drink more water. But I can't stress enough how important it is to drink water at school. Now, it might seem a lot more fun to just take an energy drink to school, but those things are sugar-filled and are not good for your health, for your energy. It is called an energy drink, but believe me, it really doesn't boost your energy as much as you would think it does. And you might be thinking, I don't want to take bland and boring water to school, but let me teach you a little hack that you guys might or might not know. Lemon. You guys want to squeeze some lemon or cut some lemon pieces up into your drink and leave it in the fridge overnight. This will make your drink a lot more flavorful, and believe me, I know this because I have been trying this out. Putting water in the fridge with lemon in it definitely improves the taste of it and makes it a lot more flavorful. And not only that, it is a lot healthier for you. Lemony. Hack number 6. Be organized. Now, there is so many pros to being organized. Now, it is very easy to be organized with these beautiful folders that you can just buy at any stationery shop. Now, these keeps your papers nice and clean and not so crinkled, if you know what I mean. Studies have shown that when kids are more organized in their school life, they tend to do better on school because it puts them in that mindset of, oh, if my things are organized, I want to study better. That is definitely something I can relate to. When my things are nice and organized and clean, I feel like I can just focus better and I can just feel so relieved. Hack number 7. Now this falls in with going to bed earlier, but getting up earlier is also super easier if you go to bed earlier. Now, why I'm saying getting up earlier is better, you have a lot more time in the morning. I can agree that nobody likes to have that morning rush and feel anxious in the morning or about, did I forget this, did I forget that? Yes, you do not want to feel like this. So getting up just an hour or 30 minutes earlier can definitely make your morning a lot more productive and better. Now, I usually get up at 6 a.m. because that gives me enough time. A lot of schools start at only 9 or 8 a.m. So this is perfect. Getting up at 6 will definitely help you pack a more nutritious lunch, have it a lot more fresher, and everything of that. Even if you don't want to pack your books the night before, waking up at 6 a.m. is definitely something you want to try because it is just so much healthier for you, and it definitely makes you feel more organized and well planned. Hack number 8, and this hack is super close to home. Anxiety. School gives us a lot of anxiety, but if you are already diagnosed with anxiety, it can be really hard to focus in school and really hard to just do your thing when you're feeling anxious all the time. So what I can tell you, and I know I'm gonna have a couple of boos at this one, but what I can tell you is, whether it's just one or two, bring a little fidget toy. Now, I know you guys are thinking, oh, what school do you go to? Schools don't allow fidget toys. But that is completely fine, because I've got a little hack for you. You're going to need a folder like this for your hack, or just any type of big book or folder. It doesn't really matter. Now, you're going to place it down like this, and make it look like you are reading. Now, while you are reading, and this is why this folder is better, because it's bigger and not a lot of people can see what you're doing. Now, when anxiety comes, there's not much you can do to keep it in, so you want to get it out in some way. Now, if you want to make it look like you're reading off of your folders, sit like this, and squish it in between the books so that nobody can see you're squishing it. Anxiety is real, guys, and don't let school stop you from treating it. Hack number 9. If your school doesn't already have uniform but you're allowed to wear whatever you want, this is for you. Wear comfy things, whether it's sweatshirts, sweatpants, or whatever. And don't let anybody talk you down about it, because if you feel comfortable in it, wear it. So, school isn't a fashion show, it's a place to learn. So if you are a lot more comfortable, you're going to be learning better for sure, guys. I can assure you that this hack is going to help you a lot. So if your school has a uniform, this hack is unfortunately not for you. But if it doesn't have uniform, this hack is super, super great. And I definitely recommend using it, guys. I definitely, definitely do. Because having a lot more comfier clothing definitely helps you learn a lot better. Because, I mean, if you're feeling uncomfortable in the clothing you're wearing, whether it's personally or just actually physically feeling uncomfortable in your clothing, you are not going to be focusing on your work. You're going to be focusing on how to get your clothing a lot more comfortable for you. So please use this hack, guys. And hack number 10 is always be yourself and don't let other people talk down to you. It is not bad to stand up for yourself, because that's what we have to do. If you are getting bullied in any way, talk to somebody that you trust. Or stand up for yourself. It doesn't always have to result into violence, but standing up for yourself is way better than actually letting them take advantage of you. So always be yourself, be kind, and be happy. There you guys go. And that was 10 life hacks for back to school. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell to notify you every time that I upload a new video. Stay cool, stay safe, stay home. Bye, my little Rainbow Land citizens. I love you guys. Bye, guys.